people who got fired on the first day of the job. What happened? They called me and told me I was let go for not showing up on my first day, which was a surprise for me since at no point after the interview had I been told that I'd been hired. This happened to me once. They called me 2 weeks later to see why I didn't start and I said I was waiting on a call. They were very nice about it and checked their phone records then called me back to start. It was really weird when I showed up and everyone was skeptically like, "Hey, why didn't you show up last week?" I got hired through a temp service to work at the local phone company, no problem, as I had done tons of telemarketing before and figured it would be working on the billing customer service end. Nope. First day, they had me on the phone with linemen who were up a telephone pole somewhere halfway across the country asking me which wire to cut. I had no clue what I was doing, and had a mini meltdown talking to my supervisor. She asked me how I could possibly not know what I was doing when I had clearly passed the test to get the job. My response was, "Test? What test?" Turns out the temp agency was supposed to give any and all applicants a test to see if they had the experience necessary to do the job. I had a call from the temp agency telling me I was fired before I got home that day. "We thought you were a hostage negotiator." I showed up and the guy that was supposed to train me got fired. No one else was available to train me apparently, so they told me I was no longer needed. I was too young to put up a fight, or ask for any alternatives. Doesn't sound like it was a nice place to work for anyway. Not me, but I got my roommate a job with my company after he graduated from the same school with the same degree I had. He graduated a semester later and due to my internship with the company I was able to put in a good word for him. He worked as a contractor for a few months until he finally landed a full-time position. He and I were living together again so we would drive in together. On his first day, he was called into a meeting. 15 minutes into the meeting, our manager came out and asked me to drive him home. Wouldn't say why. Found out they believed he faked his diploma as it read awarded posthumously, after death. He was obviously alive and I watched him take and pass most of his classes. Turns out the school fricked up and he's getting some big settlement out of it. TLDR. Company thought roommate was faking a degree because it said he was dead. School owes him a lot of monies. Damn, class is so soul sucking. But really, I'd love to get a lot of money from a little misprint like that. My wife got a job at Bob Evans when she was a teenager. Her first customer was an older man, and apparently a regular. The customer ordered a black coffee, so my wife brought him a black coffee. Apparently black coffee meant something totally different to the codger, because he wanted it with two creams and a sugar. His response to this adversity was, and like a normal person who would ask for what they really want, to throw the cup of coffee at my wife. Her entirely reasonable response was to walk away. Her manager fired her on the spot. Apparently she was supposed to ask the guy what was wrong in response to getting the coffee thrown at her. I think it's for the best that she got out of there. If some dude threw a burning hot cup of coffee at me, I think I'd be drawn to commit violence against him, regardless of his age. What a douchebag. I kind of inadvertently got a guy fired on his first day. I was working at a factory job. I had been there a couple years at this point. They had just hired a new batch of people. One of the people they just hired, let's call him Ed, I knew from school. He was a strange dude. He always had an off-putting smile on his face, like he just farted and is waiting for you to smell it. He also thought being friendly is punching your arm, which always was annoying to me. I think he wanted to be friends in school, but it just didn't really happen. We were cordial when we met in public, though. Anyway, Ed gets hired. He sees me and come over to talk for a bit. When he walks off, my supervisor pulls me to the side and says, "If that guy messes with you, let me know." Okay, weird, right? Later that day, he is being trained at a machine behind me. We were running different parts, and mine runs slower. He decides that means I suck or something. He walks up behind me, slaps the back of my head, hard enough my hat goes flying off, and yells, "Hurry up, slowpoke." My job was working with torches, so needless to say that pee me off. At lunchtime I pulled the supervisor to the side and let him know what happened, and that it was dangerous since I am handling dangerous equipment. He tells me he will take care of it. I come back from lunch, and Ed is being escorted out of the building. Come to find out, Ed thought it would be cool to brag to my supervisor that he used to kick my butt in high school all the time. As far as I knew, we were cool. I had no idea that he told them anything of the sort, because it didn't freaking happen. So, when I complained, he was insta-fired. They were protecting me from my high school bully that I didn't even know existed. This company sounds like it has your back. This is a nice company. I was a hostess at Applebee's for a day once. I was bussing a table and dropped a cup and whispered crap. They never even told me that they fired me. I found out by going into work the next day to see me not on the schedule. I tried to talk to managers and everything, no one would tell me that I was fired. It was like a bad breakup with mind games, and eventually I had to force myself into the GM's office and made him explain to me what was going on. Shadiest crap ever. Got hired. Day one after orientation. Got desk set up. Boss walked in and told us this branch was closing. Don't come tomorrow. Got 2 months severance pay. Not me, but a guy I knew. I work in the oil field. New guy comes in on night shift. I tell him to go check the giant oil tank to see how full it is. It's a tank as big as a house. He looks down inside it and uses his freaking lighter to get light. Nobody was killed. His job was eliminated for safety reasons. I wasn't fired on the first day, but I saw someone get fired. I got a job working in a grocery warehouse, driving a forklift in the freezer section. This freezer was supposed to be kept at minus 20 degrees Fahrenheit, which means they actually kept it a little colder. I once saw it at minus 46 degrees on a rainy day. Day 1. As I'm getting a brief tour around the place by a rotund middle management fellow, we see a group emerge from the freezer, one guy in the middle clutching his mouth, tears in his eyes. You know when kids dare each other to stick their tongues onto poles during winter? This guy did that of his own volition, in this incredibly cold room, and had to wait until someone stumbled upon him for rescue. He was fired on the spot. Someone didn't grow up watching A Christmas Story. I got hired as an independent contractor for some over-the-phone tech work. Hours were 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. Okay, that's perfect. I go in and get acquainted, start taking calls, and hours go by. I'm wondering when I get lunch. Newsflash. No lunch, no breaks. Independent contractor or not, pretty sure here in the US, you gotta give people some breaks and a lunch at some point in a 10-hour shift. Some kinda law about that, I feel sure. So I tell my new boss, look, I'm starving. I'm going to get something to eat. I'll be back in an hour. He said if you leave, don't bother coming back. So I left, and never went back. Sounds like you were illegally misclassified as an independent contractor. In order to be properly classified that way, you have to actually be independent. That usually means you provide your own tools, work your own hours, and are in a place of your choosing. I got a job as a waiter at an Australian themed steakhouse. No, not that one. They had me buy construction boots as part of their uniform and a pair of black shorts totaling $50. I had never worked as a waiter before, so they had me shadow one of their waitresses. I followed her for drink orders at two tables, and then she told the boss it wasn't going to work out. No idea what happened, and that was my last $50. In retrospect, that place just screams you don't want to work here, but I'm still mad about it a decade and a half later. Just started a new job, and a guy on my training group on the first day started offering people LSD. He didn't have a second day. I mean, if he was hired as an LSD salesman, he was a real go-getter. I'm assuming that wasn't the case though. Used to work at a factory that made food stuff. Guy I was trained with fell into a big vat of wet ingredients that was about to be heated up. Had I not looked behind me, he would have died. The boss went to the hospital to tell him he was fired, but they were giving him some extra pay in his check. And thus got superfood powers and restored balance to the pH scale of soup. I got a job at a daycare cooking food. I ended up getting strep throat prior to my first day. They fired me after I told them I couldn't come in because I was contagious. I got a seizure while serving someone at a new restaurant. It was my first of a 3-day trial period, so I don't think I was technically on the books yet. Needless to say, they never called me back. They should have put in you charge of martinis and other shaken drinks. When I was in between jobs, and early in my tech career, I took some temporary work. Among this work was a manufacturing outfit that needed a few thousand records digitized. Upon the early part of my discovery, I found that they already had most of this data in a giant flat file, and were bringing in only two new pieces of unique data. I found a few correlation points with just a glance, and immediately started scripting. It took around 4 hours to get my script ready, and then all I had to do was enter two pieces of unique info per record, and the script would take care of the rest. This was going to be a huge time saver, likely cutting the 5-day job to 1.5 or 2 days. I would be paid the same either way, and would be out of their hair days early, so I figured it was a win-win. The lady in charge of watching me asked me right after lunch on that first day how many records I had completed so far, and I answered her honestly. I had done 4 records, the ones I had tested my script against, but was going to blast through hundreds before that business day was done. I went back to the desk and computer they had provided me, and started banging through the stack of records. After I had only done about 2 dozen of them, a security type showed up, and escorted me out while muttering something about non-performance. I asked to be given 3 minutes to show my script to anyone that cared, but they were not interested at all. I was marched out the side door, and was never again used by that temp agency. Those folks just did not understand what I was doing, or how powerful scripting is. All they knew was that I spent the morning doing something other than the mind-numbing data entry that they had hired me for. There is a story somewhere on Reddit about a guy who automated his job scripts, spent the entire day on the internet. When they found out and fired him, he took his scripts with him and had to hire 2 people to do his old job. Some details may be incorrect. It has been a long time since I read the post. I spent the morning of my first, and only, day at a medical equipment calibration facility being introduced to the whole team. A very nice woman spent time taking me around the building, and we wound up having small talk with dozens of people from upper management to the warehouse guys. We returned to our desks and a very cute guy started talking to me. I noticed someone in an office observing this interaction. She called the nice lady into her office. The nice lady told me that was enough for the day and that we would get a fresh start the next morning. When I got home, there was a call from HR telling me not to come back. I never got an explanation. I think the woman in the office liked the cute guy and got jealous. A guy showed up on his first day, went through orientation, then out for beers with his boss and a few others. His boss was talking about his 16-year-old girl and the new guy straight-faced said, "Is she hot?" This was a 24-plus-year-old dude. His first day was his last. I've had co-workers stone-faced say to an upper management, but not technically his boss, "Tell your daughters to call me when they're in high school." I don't know how he's still around. Not me, but happened when I was working at McDonald's. New guy came in and when he saw that we were trashing patties if they had been sitting too long, he ate one. Then he started just eating them from the supply. Dude must have inhaled 10-12 patties over a couple hours after repeatedly being told to stop. Eventually, he started making himself a burger with the buns and eating it as well. Got fired first day on the job. I'm still convinced he had no real plans of working and just wanted to see how many free burgers he could eat before getting canned. Not me, but some recent graduates. So I worked on Wall Street and we had a rigorous hiring process. Almost 3-4 rounds for an entry-level MIS position. So it took about 6-8 weeks to find someone and he started. After the introduction, he started training, and mind you, we stay freaking late. 12-hour shifts. So he's training non-stop for the day and slowly everyone is trickling out. I'm assuming he was the last person to leave, because when I came in I saw an email around midnight saying, "Y'all mother suckers are crazy and this place will kill you all in a month. I'm out." Talk of the floor for about a month, and ironically some people quit because he was actually right. I'll never forget it. Of course he was right. Wall Street is awful. My friend is an AI banker and snorts coke to work 22 hours a day. Oh boy, I have a sad one. Not me actually. My brother, when he was 18 or 19, was doing this police explorers thing, where young adults interested in law enforcement ride along with cops. One day they had him go to various places and try to buy alcohol, which is illegal here in the States until you're 21. Anyway, their day was almost over, so the cop he was riding with let him go for some pizza. They took him to a mom and pop kind of pizza restaurant. Real small business, and he ordered a beer. The waitress served him without hesitation, so my brother motioned for the officer to come inside. He had been sitting out in his car. The officer was in uniform. My brother was not. Anyway, when she realizes what's happening, this young waitress just starts crying in the middle of the restaurant. Through sobs she exclaimed, "It's my first day. I didn't know. I didn't know. I'm so sorry." The officer decided not to revoke the restaurant's liquor license, but the girl lost her job. My brother came home that day laden with guilt and quit doing police explorers shortly thereafter. I'm a developer. We hired a guy who did an amazing interview. He really seemed to know his stuff and was clearly very intelligent and capable. On his first day he saw some old code in a crappy legacy app which wasn't great and he went freaking apeshit. Like, began ranting at his desk, then stood up from his desk and started shouting at his screen, then started verbally abusing the developer he thought had written the code. He hadn't. The other developer just sat and took the abuse calmly and tried to explain it wasn't his code, and anyway we knew it was old and poorly written but there was no plan for the team to rebuild it, etc. But it was futile and he barely got a word in with the other guy just shouting him down in an endless tirade. He had a full meltdown and was beyond civilized conversation. Project manager had to intervene and have an emergency meeting with the MD and the developer. They mutually agreed he wasn't right for the company. The guy eventually said he had Asperger's and had left many jobs for the same reason. Some old code in a crappy legacy app which wasn't great. That is basically every programming developer job ever, even if you are the only programmer there. I was 16 and landed my first job in a paint store mixing custom colors for customers. On my first day, I mixed a requested color, following the paint manufacturer's directions exactly. But the result turned out wrong because the formula had changed and my employer had not updated his store's formula specifications. So when the customer complained about the color variants, the boss fired me in front of everyone. Even though I had done the job correctly, it was humiliating, and left a lasting negative impression as to what's involved in joining the workplace. He did you a favor. Sounds like it would have been miserable working for him. I worked as a proofreader for a printing firm that made pay-per-view TV guides. When we were given a file, we scanned it with a wand thingy so that the system would assign it to our employee number with a timestamp. I was called into the manager's office at the end of my first day and let go. I asked if my work was poor and she said, "No, there were no errors. The reason I was being fired is that I was finishing the files too quickly. We can't bill the client if you finish the file in less than an hour." No one ever told me that we had a soft, minimum work time. Basically, I was fired for being too efficient. I once got hired by Radio Shack when I was 17. As in, I filled out their application, handed them my resume, went through two interviews, one on the phone, one in person, and then was scheduled for my first day. I went in my first day, and they told me they didn't realize I was 17. They only hire 18 and above. They made me go through that entire process for nothing. I got someone fired on their first day, though not a very exciting story. I was working at a tannery, where leather is made, in charge of environmental control, making sure we didn't put too much heavy metal down the drains. This kid turns up, I give him the job that I'd been doing twice a day for 6 months and then I wander off to pretend to look busy somewhere else. I come back about half an hour later to check on him and he's sitting in the break room. "What's going on?" "Oh, it was too smelly so I've stopped." I don't know if you can call it being fired if they're just refusing to work though. Not me, but a young girl we hired based on a manager recommendation. It was a software developer job. First day, I started giving her some knowledge about the system. Every time I say something she would ask, "What's that?" Like, "Here we use XML or JSON. Okay, what are those?" I will explain, then proceed to say, "And we use Java here and PHP here. I'm sorry, what are these now?" I told that manager if she comes tomorrow he will have to fire her himself. She didn't. I work in software development as well, and though I've never seen anyone gone on their first day, I've seen quite a few people who only lasted a week or two. Sadly, we are just one department at a large company that is mostly non-digital, so our recruiters don't really know anything about what to look for in software developers. Janitor job at a hospital. cleaning bathrooms and the patients' rooms. An old lady laying in her bed called me over and said she was born in Germany and she'd learned to speak English but couldn't read it very well. She had a get well card from someone and asked me to read the poem inside. I did. Someone reported me because I wasn't supposed to interact with patients. Got fired before lunch. Not me, but a kid where I used to work was chosen the day he started for a random drug test. They did these once every few months. He said, no problem. Clocked out, and never returned. He probably just realized the job wasn't for him. My dad worked at bakery in Nantucket for one day. It had a reputation for having never closed in something like 100 years. He was a dishwasher or something else in the back, and thought he'd try to impress his boss by cleaning the donut machine. Somehow he broke it, causing the machine to spill dough and oil and water etc. all over the floor of the restaurant and destroy the entire kitchen. The restaurant survived hurricanes, floods, and fires, but one day of my dad closed the place for the first time in the better part of a century. There once was a baker from Nantucket, who grabbed him a sponge and a bucket. He started a chore, which closed the whole store, so the owners just told him to suck it. I had a worthless piece of crap roommate who I got to witness get fired. His first day of work washing dishes at a Tex-Mex place, he called in because he missed the bus. There was going to be a bus 30 minutes later, but he thought it better to completely miss his first day than to be at all late. The next day, the same crap happened exactly as the first day, except that he was then invited to not bother ever coming in. Maybe he was idiom dyslexic. Hey, better never than late. Not me, but story I heard when I joined a company about a week or two after I started. Apparently the guy was writing an email about how bad weird he thought the place was, and meant to send it to the guy who started on the same day as him, Rob. Just so happens the director was also called Rob. He sent the email to the director. Director fired him straight away. Went in for my first day and the executives are apparently at the building talking to my manager who was gonna get me going. Found out within 5 minutes the company got bought out and we were all fired. Went through drug tests and interviews for nothing. I got touched in the balls for nothing. Stupid physicals. Frick that place. I know a guy with a very similar story. He started working for IBM. Within a month of his start date, they did a riff and he was offered a huge severance. He walked away a very happy person. Cleaned houses for old people. Fired up one of their vacuum cleaners. It made a sound like a siren. So I jokingly yelled, "The Germans are coming." A common response for me. I'm from a country previously occupied by Germans. The old people were old enough. I started working part-time last Christmas at a large supermarket chain. And they were hiring pretty much anyone and so didn't have uniforms for everyone. So they ended up giving us aprons with the supermarket's name at the front and to wear it until they get our uniforms. There was this one guy that during the grup interview went on about how he was turning his life around, was heavily influenced by drugs when he was younger, and was starting his own business on the side. Sounded like a pyramid scheme. Refused to wear the apron as he doesn't want to wear that gay crap. He was promptly fired. I technically got fired while I was still in training. I was going to be doing a seasonal retail job and had been doing a few training days. They told us we weren't going to be working before our training was done, which was a relief since my first day of training was a few days before Black Friday and my second day of training was right after. Apparently, this wasn't the case as I was scheduled to work on Black Friday. I didn't know since no one told me. My manager was like, "So and so told you that you were working that day," and I was like, "I don't know who so and so is," which was true. I didn't know anyone except the people in my department, and this person was in HR or something. So they let me go before my second day of training was done. Was pretty mad considering they didn't actually tell me I was scheduled, but there was nothing I could do about it. All in all, I'm kinda glad. It wasn't something I was particularly excited to do. It was just my first job offer in months and I needed something. Thankfully found a better job a month later. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. bye for now.